What's up, Team Unaltered? Zach Munoz here to talk about a big topic, why you are not losing weight. Now, at Unaltered, we do provide nutritional supplements to help you take you to that next level of performance to achieve your goals, but it does not just stop there, right? Supplements is only a fraction of what it takes to achieve your goals. You have nutrition, exercise, so here we want to make sure that we're your go-to source for all information related to supplements, exercise, and nutrition. So I want to specifically dissect the topic of insulin. Now, I know in today's fast-paced world, we want the quick and easy solution to things, but I promise if you just stick with me for the next few minutes to understand this key concept of how the body works, you will be achieving your goals a lot more effectively. So let's get started. All right, so the first concept to understand is insulin. Now, insulin is an extremely important hormone when it comes to transporting our blood sugar and storing it later for energy, right? Now, insulin acts as a transporter of glucose, right? Glucose is what gives us energy. This is ultimately converted into ATP, adenosine triphosphate, which again is our body's main source of energy. So anything from walking to your mailbox, going to the kitchen, any sort of physical movements, exercise requires this source of energy, which ultimately requires insulin. So the insulin acts as a transporter for glucose. Now, whatever glucose that our body does not use immediately for energy gets stored in our muscles and in our liver for fuel and energy later on, right? But here's the problem. So when we continue to eat an excess amount of sugar and our muscles and our liver can no longer hold any more glucose, that glucose gets converted into what's called triglycerides, which is a chain of three fatty acids. Now, here's the problem. Those triglycerides get pushed into our fat cells, which is ultimately stored into the body as fat. Now, the main problem is that when our fat cells can no longer hold any more fatty acids, those fatty acids are forced to be pushed into our liver and our pancreas. Now, this is critical for overall health, right? Our liver and our pancreas is what helps for nutrient absorption. So oftentimes, when we continue to eat excess sugar, we might feel, you know, a spike in energy and good for 30 minutes or so, but then we feel that crash later on in the day. It's because of this problem right here. Our fat cells get overflown with fatty acids. They become inflamed because they can't hold any more. And then those fatty acids are getting stored in our liver and our pancreas, and we can no longer absorb nutrients the same way that we used to be. So we have lack of energy. We get tired often. We lose performance when it comes to our training in the gym, right? And ultimately, the end result, if we keep doing this and our fat cells continue to become inflamed and inflamed and inflamed, our body becomes insulin resistant, right? It's almost like a rubber band. When you stretch a rubber band 1,000 times, it loses its elasticity, right? It's the same concept with insulin. When you call on insulin so many times, your body stops producing it at the same rate that it used to. And that's a huge problem because, again, insulin is responsible for providing our bodies with energy when we need it, right? And we have other negative side effects like high blood pressure, osteoporosis, right? So aside from transporting glucose, insulin also helps to your body to absorb magnesium. Now, magnesium is an extremely important mineral when it comes to relaxing your muscles, right? So when your body becomes insulin resistant because you keep having this excess amount of sugar, your body is no longer able to absorb this magnesium. And what ends up happening is that your blood vessels end up constricting, right? It's almost like taking a hose and then squeezing it. And then you end up having high blood pressure. Same thing with osteoporosis, right? Low bone density, right? Insulin also helps for the processes of testosterone, growth hormone, right? Your body's natural hormones. Testosterone and growth hormone are used to build up your bones, right? So again, when your body becomes insulin resistant, you start having all these sort of negative side effects. You no longer can produce growth hormone and testosterone the same way you did. And then as an end result, you have lower bone density because you can't build up your bones the way you used to, and you're prone to osteoporosis. So insulin is a huge thing. You want to make sure, guys, that when you're going shopping for your food at the grocery store, that you're really examining the nutrition facts on the back of the label, right? Sometimes we go and we see, you know, a microwavable dinner that we think looks healthy from face value in the front of the package, right? Great marketing. But then when you flip the package over and you look at the nutrition facts, it's loaded with sugar, right? So in order to achieve our weight loss goals and really get the most out of our training, we want to make sure that we're really looking at what we're putting into our bodies, right? How much sugar are we really eating? And we don't necessarily have to be overweight. You can be skinny and still be having this issue where your fat cells are inflamed, right? So we want to make sure that to be healthy and really achieve our goals when it comes to weight loss, that we're really looking at our sugar intake. Oftentimes, if you just take sugar out of your diet, you'll lose 10 pounds right away, right? So sugar is a big thing, and the concept of understanding how sugar affects your insulin levels is also a huge topic. So that's today's topic, guys. Make sure, again, that every time you go shopping that you're really examining those nutrition facts and lowering that sugar intake that you're having in your diets. All right, guys, so that was today's topic. A quick rundown. I know that it was a lot of information to absorb, so a quick summary is that we really want to be observant with the amount of sugar that we're intaking into our diet, because again, ultimately, when we have too much sugar, our bodies become insulin resistant, and it's no longer able to transport the glucose into our muscles and our liver that we need for energy to perform all of our daily functions, right? Between exercising, walking to the kitchen, any sort of physical movement, and ultimately to be able to achieve our fitness goals, right? Whether it's weight loss, increasing performance, building lean muscle, any kind of fitness goal that we have can be greatly affected by our bodies becoming insulin resistant. So make sure that you're watching out for your sugar intake. Now, make sure that you subscribe to this channel, turn the notifications on so that you can stay tuned with all the other awesome videos that we have coming out. We want to try to provide a different topic with each video to give you guys the most information possible to really help you achieve your fitness goals, right? Supplements is only a fraction. You still have nutrition and exercise. So we want to be that go-to source for all of your needs to help you achieve the ultimate you. So subscribe to the channel, turn the notifications on, visit unalteredathletics.com where you can read our blog posts on exercise and nutrition. We have exercise videos as well. So make sure you guys go to unalteredathletics.com and you stay tuned with this video series that we have at the Unaltered Athletics YouTube. Zach Munoz out.